foodborne diseases affect everyone. We've seen examples like the fenugreek E. coli outbreak in Germany, the melamine contamination scandal in China, and they are examples that even highly developed countries can get big problems with foodborne disease, but they're only the tip of the iceberg. There's a lot more foodborne diseases than you see with these highly publicized outbreaks. And when you go to the developing world, the problem is even a lot bigger. There it affects many people, particularly young children and their mothers, who are very vulnerable. We also know that foodborne diseases are very diverse. It's a very complex problem. There's a lot of different agents that can cause foodborne disease. And they lead to very different diseases. Diarrheal diseases, for example, that normally will cure within a week. But even the diarrheal diseases have long-term impacts. Children in developing countries can suffer from malnutrition, from impaired growth because of the diarrheal diseases. And we're only now learning to understand those problems. And diarrheal disease may lead to a paralytic disease known as Guillain-Barré syndrome, for example. Very few people realize that. And when you think about parasites, they can cause epilepsy. Chemicals can cause cancer, infertility, intellectual disabilities, kidney diseases. So foodborne diseases occur very frequently and they can be very severe. And until now, the real impact of those diseases has not been investigated and documented properly.